Don't be so high and mighty that you don't take advantage of the humble opportunities that are granted to you. When I look back, I didn't like school at all. You might say I hated it. And I've thought a lot about that, you know, because I thought, well, there were reasons. You know, I was a very fast reader. I could get through the books that were given to us in English class generally in the first day. And that wasn't really appreciated, I would say. But there were things, and I was bored a lot as a teenager and got into a reasonable amount of trouble, not an unreasonable amount, but then, you know, there were sports teams and there were attempts to organize plays, and there were things that I didn't do that I could have, that would have made my life better. But I was too cynical, maybe, to take full advantage of them. And like, I did work when I was a kid. I worked in restaurants as a dishwasher, short order cook, that sort of thing. That was a really good decision. I think my fondest memories in some ways of my adolescence are memories of working in the restaurant. But don't, like, life is very difficult. And in order to thrive with this difficult life, if an opportunity is presented to you, you shouldn't be so arrogant that you dismiss it. And it's really easy to be arrogant as a teenager, especially if you're smart, because you think, well, I'm smarter than everybody else. It's like, actually, no, there's lots of people that are a lot smarter than you. You just haven't met them yet. And you're not as smart as you think you are, besides, right. And other people aren't as dumb as you think they are either.
There's different kinds of smart.
There certainly is. Yes. And wise beats smart. So I would say if you're 16 and your life isn't so happy, it's like, look around and see if there are opportunities that people are granting you, even imperfect opportunities, because they're going to be imperfect, that you could exploit, let's say, in the proper way and learn and grow. I had this teacher, Ada Paul. She's dead now. I really liked her in grade 4. She was an organist at the church. And when I was 14, 15, she offered to teach me how to play the organ. And it was a big organ, you know. And I, for a variety of reasons, wasn't really that into the idea. And so I kind of went, and then a couple of times I skipped it, and it just sort of fell apart, you know. And which was pretty rude of me, obviously, because she went out of her way to offer this. And, like, that's a good example, because, like, it wasn't cool to play the organ. It wasn't cool to do any. I don't know what it was like when you grew up. When I grew up, it wasn't cool to do anything.
Yeah. It's still like that out there.
True.
Yeah. So, like, doing anything wasn't cool.
Right.
It's like, well, it wouldn't have been so bad to learn to play the organ.
Yeah.
You know?
And also to learn from you know, someone with more experience than you.
Well, it was actually someone who cared for me somewhat and who was really a great person. She was a great teacher. Like, I really liked Ada Paul. She was, and I betrayed her trust, you know? It's like, that wasn't very bright.
I think we all have memories like that as kids, you know?
Yeah.
But I think that advice is good to even young adults, even to adults, really, to pause and appreciate the opportunities and the doors that are always open to them.
Well, here's
and the experiences that are always available.
Well, here's an idea.
Yeah.
So life is brutal, and what you have to set against that is possibility. And you might say, well, life is so brutal that you have to utilize all the possibility that comes your way. You know, so an opportunity manifests itself and you turn it down, you ignore it, you let it drift away. It's like, that's one thing that you had against the horror of existence that you let go of. You let go of 10 of those things, man, you're on the street.
Right.
And it's no fun there. And it doesn't get better. And so there is a possibility that if you utilized all the possibility that was offered to you, that your life would be straight and clean and engaging and acceptable and positive. And that's worth finding out if that's the case, because it might be true.